working principle of DC motor. The motor is a device which converts the electric energy into mechanical energy. Structure: a rectangular coil called armature, comprising a large number of turns of insulated copper wire wrapped on the iron core made of insulated sheets to cut down the eddy currents. The core and the coil can rotate between the two poles of a strong horseshoe U-shaped magnet. The two terminals of the coil are connected to two metal halves of a split cylinder commutator, such that the separating plane between the cylinder halves is perpendicular to the plane of the coil. The two halves are insulated from each other and capable of rotating around the axis of the coil. Two graphite brushes each is connected to one half of the metal cylinder. A battery, its poles are connected to the brushes during operation of the motor. When the plane of the coil is parallel to the lines of the magnetic flux, the two graphite brushes touch the two metallic cylinder halves. Thus, the electric current passes in the coil. By applying Fleming's left-hand rule, direction of magnetic field from north pole to the south pole and direction of the middle finger or current in the left side conductor indicate the direction of the mechanical force. The same for the right side conductor. Direction of magnetic field from north pole to the south pole and direction of the middle finger or current indicate the direction of the mechanical force. Two forces equal in magnitude and opposite in direction affect the two sides of the coil, producing a torque that leads to the rotation of the coil continuously about its axis in the same direction. Thus, the two metallic cylinder halves interchange their position relative to the two brushes each half cycle. As a result, the electric current reverses direction once each half cycle. As the coil rotates, the torque decreases gradually till it vanishes when the plane of the coil becomes perpendicular to the lines of the magnetic flux and the brushes touch the insulator between the two cylinder halves. But the coil, having gained a momentum, continues rotation due to inertia. The plane of the coil becomes parallel to the magnetic flux once more, and the two metallic cylinder halves interchange their position. Thus, the direction of the electric current is reversed in the coil, which forms the torque maximum value that helps to keep the rotation of the coil in the same direction. As the coil rotates, the torque decreases gradually till it vanishes when the plane of the coil becomes perpendicular to the lines of the magnetic flux. But the coil continues its rotation due to inertia till it finalizes a complete revolution and becomes parallel to the flux lines again. This is repeated each complete revolution.